Oh, tech rabbit here again. Now we're going to install the operating system on the new computer. So I'm going to go for Windows 10. And my suggestion is that one should download the image directly from Microsoft from this address, so that one can avoid getting irrefutable images. And when you go there, you get to this kind of a page where you can create the Windows 10 installation media as one of the options. Now, if you land on this page and you don't get English, for those not in the US or English-speaking countries, then you can actually scroll down, way down, and you can actually change it here with this global picture view. And this image creator tool, basically what it provides you is that it provides you with an option to put the operating system image onto a flash drive. And you should have a flash drive like, well, I don't know if a 4 gig works anymore, but this is 8 gigs. So, if I remember correctly, I've been using it forever, so I actually don't remember. What is the size? Should actually check it. Oh, this is an 8 gig. So anyway, the way this works is that you can download the media creation tool. You press this button and then you download a piece of software. Actually take quite a while to store. And then you need to plug this into the USB port of the computer you're using to actually create the installation media, so you can't actually do it on an empty computer. Agreement. I just said okay. I've actually already created this file. I'll just go through the steps and that's relatively simple. While it's doing the startup thing, I can say that basically it supports actually select various different editions of Windows 10, and when you take Windows 10, then you can either have the home edition or the pro. It doesn't make a difference between those two, so it just says Windows 10, and then you can, when it comes here, you say upgrade the PC you're currently on. You don't definitely don't want to do that, or you say create installation media. And then you say next. And here you can select, okay, what language version do you want, what edition. And it, as I said, it only says Windows 10, so you can't actually select if you want to have home or pro. And so, like, even if you say use the recommended options for this PC, that doesn't access to the Pro version. And then you say next, and then you say, okay, where do you want to create a ISO file, which means you can burn, you can create a CD, but I don't think anybody does that anymore. And then you can take the, or actually now you can select the USB flash drive option, and then you can select which flash drive to use. I won't actually go next because I've actually already created it. So we can actually just cancel this now. Let's take the USB media, and then once you have it, I need to change this one. I'm going to plug this into a USB port. Smart enough to boot onto that automatically. Yes, it is. So now it's starting up from here, starting up the installation from the USB drive. So, and then we can start with selecting language. So I, even if I'm not in a natively English speaking country, I usually take the English. Oh, of course, use the correct mouse. Not use the original. Okay, so that's in time and currency formats. Then. Also, I'm not really exposing that much if I say I'm in Sweden. Swedish for Sweden, and then the keyboard layout goes automatically to Swedish. And then next. Install now. And then it asks for the product key. And here I will just pause to set. So here I will put in my product key and then continue.